The normally the poor people generally the Burmese situation affected them the same. Their lands are confiscated, their people are killed, extrajudicial killing, they are forced relocation, forced pottery, women were raped, the same fate with the others nationalities. But after the ceasefire, some parts of poor population, some area, some controlled by the ceasefire group, a small area, a small population, get a little bit relief from the others' suppressions or by the Burma army. So they have some economic booming, some a little bit well-to-do for them. But among 2 million population of the Pao, that group is very small percentage, only 10% or 20%. But majority Pao are stay poor, stay uneducated, stay discriminated and marginalized, stay now. The inside Burma, inside the Pao territory, the condition is they cannot enjoy any amount of freedom. They are severely controlled by the military all the time. They are subject to human rights violation anytime by the ruling military regime and the frontline Burma army. So the poor population who escaped to the border now, who were stay along the border and who were stay in town as an illegal migrant, at least they can enjoy some kind of freedom. And at least some villagers along the border can enjoy some kind of hill people status under Thai law.